Hi everyone, welcome to Handicrafts A to Z. My name is Alena Salimova and today I'm going to show you how to prepare the how to make the first part of the carpet, the edge itself, and how to prepare the warp for actual weaving knots. So let's get started. Okay, so I finished the warping and I got sure that all the warps are in the correct place. I placed some threads, which are, I don't know, some kind of thread. And I've got the paper strip. This is just to keep the carpet line straight. And I got the heddles down. And when I use this little warp, the carrot warp, weft, and pick up about 15 centimeters, leave about 10 centimeters here to secure it, and using a beater I slightly beat it up. I don't pull too hard, I don't leave it too loose. In carpets we place the weft in, not in one piece, but doing this in small pieces because it's very easy to make. Keep it straight, because obviously you cannot beat the with the heddle. And place the heddles up. Put this first one into neutral, raising the back one. I know I have to find a decent way to place my loom. So I've got one heddle up. And I've got the second heddle. Oops. Yes, obviously the bedroom sofa is not a good idea to keep the loom. And again, we change the shift and going back way. I can beat up here and also from the other side. I place the weft inside. This would secure the thread. Keep it to the wrong side of the carpet. Continue. So if you see, I finished here, so I pick up the next thread, up thread, and I'm beating it lightly. Don't beat too hard, there's no need for that yet. Once I finish this part, so you can see the thread is secured, I place the heddles into neutral position and we're gonna make something that we call Sumakh stitch. Okay, for Sumakh stitch, you place the thread before the warp, you pick up two threads, which is the pear. Insert the weft shuttle under the thread and tie the knot. The next thing, you pick the next two stitches. Again, make it a bigger angle. Okay, you pick up the thread, the warp. The weft is on your thumb, and you place the shuttle underneath and throw. And you tie the knot again. Don't pull it too tight, because otherwise you will shrink the rug. And don't leave it too loose, otherwise it will fall apart once you remove it from the loom. Okay, so you pick up the next two, again, on the thumb, right underneath, and pull tight. This will even out the density, and it will also keep the rug in place. There's actually a technique when the whole carpet is made this way, just using different colors of weft. It's usually made with silk. Okay, so we pick up two next. And pull gently. You might want to use the beater. Keep the line straight. It actually doesn't really matter, because anyway you still have to use the beater once you finish the roll. And next, again, up, underneath, and pull. Again we go, pick up two threads, up, under, and pull. Again, make it this way. So I got the thread on my thumb and I shaped the triangle here. I placed the shuttle under the thread and I pull it. So we got our beginning thread secured. We are securing our warp. And we'll work all the way down to the end. Got my little assistant sitting around, which is Tart the Cat. He's a bit camera shy, so you might hear his noise, but not seeing him. And so it goes like this till the end of the row. That's the most boring part, except of warping. And you can imagine weavers working on huge looms, something like 1.5-2 meter carpets. It's pretty boring. That's why the weavers in the big shops, they always sing. Him. Tart the Cat. Heat it up a bit. And as you can see, we've got this nice little rib here. It should be beaten a bit. A bit. So it goes like this, and I will show you how it looks like on the finished piece. I've already placed it on for framing, and this part is called sunbul, but over here you can see the sumakh. And so the other type that's the framing that's called sunbul, which is, I will show you once we finish it. And that's the beginning of the carpet. So we do it twice. We do it once we start the carpet. Then we weave plain for about 1 centimeter. Then we make another row of sumakh, and then we start actually making knots. Okay, so we continue. And I pick up two. Sorry. We pick up two. Under. Two. Under. Pick up two threads. Under and pull. Two threads. Under and pull. No, I don't need my hair in there. Okay, make sure you don't pull too tight. Because this is what might happen. Come on, camera. Tune up. So if I pull it too tight, you see what happens? You make a hole. But the whole reason of this thing is to spread the warp evenly. Don't push it too close, and don't keep it aside. So we go like this for the entire row, and the next about 20 minutes. So I might just switch off the camera for now. And once I finish, I'll be back with it. So I finished the row, and I placed the heddle down. And again, I split my carpet for about 3 pieces. And then insert the weft. I'm beating it up. Not too loose, not too tight. Just to keep it straight. And we do the next. This is just a plain weave. Double heddle. Okay, when you weave, right here I've got a mistake. As you can see, I skipped one, and I skipped one here. So what I do, I go back. That's why we never place the warp through the hole. Carpets straight away, so it's easy to fix the mistake just kept it on 10 centimeters rather than 1 meter and a half. Okay, so the rest is okay. Change the heddle. Yes, it's much more easier to work on the professional looms, but unfortunately I don't have a place in my house for one, so I'll take half of the room, even the smallest one. Okay, so avoid this situation when you skip the thread. What we usually do once we change the shift, you just run your hand through the warp. That would separate the threads. And again, slightly beating up, making sure that your edges are straight. I work like this for another 8 to 10 rows, so I can make 1.5 centimeter, which is about 1/2 inch of the plain weave. Shift the heddles again, going down. And again, I run my fingers through. And keep the edge straight. As you can see, after they've done the Sumakh stitch, the warp is dispersed evenly and more regular now. Okay, so I've done the three rows, so I'll have to make another three. I found it easier if you release the first heddle, then you go to the up in the back heddle. I then place the first. It's easier. Okay, so it's, yeah, probably for the next tutorial I'll find a better place. But for the moment, that's all I got now. As you see, I don't pull it tight and I don't lose the white weft just as it goes, because when the placing the blue or red weft is slightly different. Okay, we're going down again, down the heddles. One and two. Pretend that we're playing the harp to get the warp straight, release it, and again. Tension on the edges is slightly different, so it just goes down a bit. That's okay, we'll fix it when we do the knots themselves. Actually, it doesn't really matter which side you beat, the triangle one or the straight one. Which side is more convenient for you? I find it easy to beat this side, the knots, and this one with a weft. Okay, we're going up. Release. And beating. So I'll do one more roll of the plain weave on peg. Peg, whatever. So I have to go back here again to make another roll of sumakh. Straight. You can use the wooden beater, it works just the same. It's just that this one is designed for the fine carpets, which is 60 to 70 knots per 4 inches. Back to neutral position. And neutralize it. Okay. And again, we pick up 2 threads. Make a triangle. Pass the weft through the triangle. Pick up the next 2. And so it goes like this. Pick up 2. Under the warp weft. And pull tight. Well, not so tight. Again. So it goes. And beat it up to place it. Okay, so I'll switch off the camera again and we'll continue in a couple of seconds. Okay, so I've done the second row of sumakh, and also made the 2 rows of plain weave. And right now my heddles are up, And this is the last roll that I made with the white warp, white weft. And now I have to include the blue one. The way I warped it, I have to work, make notes when the heddles are down. So while they are up, I add the blue thread. And then go to the back, place it to the back. So it doesn't show on the right side of the carpet. This is just adding a new thread here. And I go with heddles down. I don't need... Just a second. My wool yarn just got crazy. I don't need it right now. Okay, heddles down. Line straight, and with the blue one or the red one, depends on you choose, we make the smaller distance, because with this thread you have to recall the ancient Spanish colors. If you remember, they got the threads, the cloth going on all around like eights. This is what we're gonna do with the blue one. So starting from the edge, beat up very lightly with just a little corner here. So I'll probably use just once, at least four or five brushes, sides of the brush, the 1 millimeter. I carefully beat up the blue warp weft so that it doesn't leave the white marks. Generally, if I finish the row here, I will show you the do's and don'ts. Okay, as you can see, you cannot see any warp here between. Seems like you've got a nice sewing machine stitch, but with over here, I deliberately made a mistake. This is what we shouldn't do. And so I just release, and again, beat up very lightly so that these two teeth of the picker, of the beater, pick up the thread, lightly pull it down, and then beat. That's why I got the triangle very high, and I keep the thread loose like this. I don't pull it. And also, do not over try the loops like this. There also should be avoided. So I keep it free, but not too much. This is the first row that we prepare for the actual knots. Okay, so I've done this part. Add more to work and continue beating up. The reason we're doing this is we are separating the threads. So when we pick up the thread for the knot, it's easy to see which one we're working on. Like, we pick up this, and then we pick up the second one. Okay. So our thread should run freely. And once we're done, we can beat up everything to one level. Again, make the pick. As you can see, this is the thread we already wrapped around. The one goes down, goes above, and I pull the thread and again. You see, got the mistakes here, so I release it. There's also a problem with the tension. If the tension is right, you won't have any problem. If the tension is loose, you might experience these gaps. Again, so I slightly pull it up. And it goes like this until you get all the row done. So you should not have any white spaces when working with the blue weft. Again. It's very difficult when you start weaving, but once you get used to it, very easy. And once we finish the row, we don't change the shift. Don't shift the heddles. We will continue with actually knots themselves. That will be in another tutorial, hopefully within a week time. So I've got, well, we have about 2 weeks from my study, so I'll try to do as much as possible done over the holiday season. So I wish you everyone Merry Christmas and Happy New Year. As you can see, this part of the loom is warped fully, so the tension is a bit less than on the left side. Plus, it's uncomfortable to work if you're right-handed, working from left to right. Okay, so I've almost finished. Again. Yes, this part is a bit okay. So this looks more or less normal, except of maybe this one, but that has to be done. Straightening up the tension. Okay, so that's it for today, and you can now you can pick up the pattern and get all the wool that you want to use, and see you soon. Bye.